Hey everybody, I'm TBGhunter and welcome back to more Fallout New Vegas. Last time we finally made it to Prim after spelunking out in the wasteland for a bit. And in this part we're going to figure out what the heck is going on here in Prim because apparently the NCR are having a bit of a convict issue. So let's head on over because this seems to be the place of command. I'm just a random guy wearing leather armor, no need to mind me. You're there. You look like someone who's somewhat important.
I'm Lieutenant Hayes of the New California Republic Army, 5th Battalion, 1st Company. What's your business?
What are you doing out here?
We were sent out here to hold back the tide of convicts from the correctional facility. As you can probably tell, we aren't doing the kind of job we could be doing.
What's the problem?
The mission isn't a problem. The problem is with supplies. The convicts are better armed and organized than our intel initially suggested. I'm trying to get some reinforcements here, maybe some guns with some firepower, but shit. Things are just going slow.
All right, well, tell me about this correctional facility.
Most people just call it NCRCF. That's NCR Correctional Facility. A little bit ago, the convicts there staged a coup, killed the guards that weren't able to escape. And I've been ransacking the area since then.
Do you have any information on them?
Not much. They've taken to calling themselves powder gangers, mostly because they've taken to using the explosives meant to clear boulders as weapons. They got organized faster than I would have thought, most of them at least. Thankfully, the small group in town here seemed to have split off from the main force, so they aren't getting anything in the way of support.
Well, you know, for the fact that it probably wasn't the smartest idea to give a gang of convicts access to explosives and weapons that could kill people, and you're a bunch of idiots, you know that? Well, maybe not NCR in general, but yeah, the guards who were there, they had it coming. As dickish as that sounds. I had something else to ask, and that something else is goodbye. Oh, thank you for a little bit of respect and some authority.
Almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter.
I don't know about that. I mean, a nuclear winter would mean that I'd have to detonate another nuclear weapon, and I don't think the people out here would like that a lot.
I'm Sergeant McGee of the New California Republic Army, 5th Battalion, 1st Company. If you want to talk about something, speak to Lieutenant Hayes.
Where are you from?
I'm from Hub originally, but it's been a long time since I saw it. I'm on my second tour here. Most non-commissioned officers are.
Well, okay. Feels like every NCR officer's sand right in their face because we're in the desert, damn it. Just gonna yoink and yoink. I don't think they'll need it. What's my karma at? Poundergainers, they hate me. Let's see. My karma, where is my karma at? Am I missing something? Special status. I'm probably walking right past where my karma and stuff stands, but whatever.
It's been a long tour. All I can think about now is going
All I can think about is killing some convicts who truly deserve it. So I bet you, Boy Scouts, I will be able to take out all the convicts in this entire town using only a laser pistol. So let's go. I got some murdering to do. And already I can see a couple shacks. We'll see if there's anything worthwhile in them. No! Aside from, you know, the rust on the walls and possibly splintered floors, I would actually live in this place. It looks really comfortable. Not seeing anything in the way of good supplies. Wait. This is a burnt book. Alright, nothing to see here. Move along. What? Mail. No mail for me. What about the other building? Because I'm sure there has to be something in the way of supplies there. Survey says... explosions! Hmm. 308 rounds, 308. If I found a hunting rifle, I can find... it would be really great. There's a reloading bench. Can I make anything? Break down 9mm, Magnum, 12 gauge. 308, Magnum ammo. I'll make some ammo. Why not? I mean, it's not like we're gonna run out of it. Anything in the desk? Nope. Probably with the big empty sign. Oh, God. Sorry. I'll just take this cowboy repeater. It's obvious you two don't seem to have any need for it. You know what? This town needs a new sheriff. A sheriff like me. I'll give these convicts a true taste of wasteland justice. Pew pew! Alright. Enough of that shtick. Let's just keep going. So far, nothing though. For a second, I actually thought I saw a Nuka-Cola Quantum there, and that would have been like, Well, looks like we finally found trouble. Or it found me. I made a pact that I would kill all of you with a laser pistol, and that's what I damn well plan to do. Zap, you're dead. I don't know why, but every time I just hear the sound of their... Every time I get a critical on their head, it just sounds so satisfying. I am a terrible human being. Merc Adventure, tire iron. Can never have enough tire irons in your life. Cleaver, jet, pack of cigarettes. So far, nothing. Well, let's head in here. I'm sure there's like 50 of them waiting at me with guns drawn.
I don't know what it was brought you to Prim, youngster, but you might want to rethink your plans. Town's gone to hell.
Well, I saw that you needed a new sheriff, so I'm here to replace the role. By the way, who are you?
Johnson Nash is my name. Husband to Ruby Nash. Lived in Prim going on 8 years now, thick and thin. I'm a trader primarily, for what it's worth with things like they are. I also run the local Mojave Express outpost.
Well, I'm a courier from the Mojave Express. You're just the guy I've been looking for.
Well, I don't got any work right now, sorry to say.
Well, I lost a package I was supposed to deliver. Not my fault! I was ambushed.
I'll tell you whatever I can. You have a delivery order you can show me?
Here's what I can tell you about the job.
Oh, so you're talking about one of them packages. That job had strange written all over it. But we couldn't turn down the cats.
And what do you mean, strange?
That cowboy robot had us hire 6 couriers. Each was carrying something a little different. Pair of dice, chess piece, that kind of stuff. Last word I have from the office, it looked like payment had been received for the other 5 jobs. Guess it was just your chip that didn't make it. First deadbeat we hired to do the job canceled. Hope a storm from the divide skins him alive. Well, that's where you came in.
Wait, he canceled?
Yeah, got this look when he saw you next down on the courier list. His expression turned right around. Asked me if your name was for real. I said, sure as lack of rain, you were still kicking. Then he turned down the job, just like that. I asked if he was sure it was good money. No, let Courier 6 carry the package. That's what he said. Like the Mojave sort you out or something. Then he just up and walked out.
Feels as though the music in the background is somewhat fitting for this conversation. Do you know who he was or where he went or anything?
No idea. Sounds like you two had a history for him to act like that. And turn down the money, too. Hope he didn't see any trouble in that package of yours. Maybe he thought your name was bad luck. Enough for me to say.
Well, some men stole my package. Stop snickering. A man in a checkered suit and some thugs. Did they pass this way?
Well, now that you mention it, a few nights back, one of the townies was out scavenging for supplies. He said he saw a fellow with a daisy suit come through with some of them Great Khan misfits. They was talking about a chip.
Yeah, well, that son of a bitch shot me. I need to know the best way to get to him.
Well, for that, your best bet is going to be talking to Deputy Beagle. Since they came to town, he was keeping a good bit of notes on him, and he was slinking around Bison Steve when your pretty boy friend came through. He may have heard where they were going.
Interesting. Mission, delivery. Is there anything else I need to know about the delivery? No. Alright, well, we got a destination, so let's get going. Off to the hotel. Who knows, maybe we can finally find a nice room to rent. Also, would you go away, lamp? Now, if I can only find the right doors. There they are. Probably with the big light shining down upon them is probably a hint enough to know where the doors are. Oh god. And already immediately spotted. Come on. Zap. Zap. My zap. Dead. And... dead. Uh-oh. Reload. Reload! Great. Step back. And... Good luck reloading with that one, asshole! Also, good luck reloading now that you're dead. Alright, you know what? Screw the laser pistol. I'm going in shotgun. We're going in close quarters, so we're gonna need something to give a little spread. Steady? Eh, why not? Let's see. Ooh, there's a door. And doors usually lead to something good. Locked hard, but you know what? Screw it, I'm hacking. Yeah, this is the first time we've hacked. So basically what you have to do is you have to match up the password. Like right there it says 2 out of 7 correct. So 2 letters out of that combination are correct. If we mess this up, we will be locked out and we will have to lockpick our way in if we wanted to go in. However, if I can find any, there we go. We remove a dud, it can actually either A, get rid of unneeded passwords, or B, refill our attempts. So let's see. Well, apparently cunning is not that. Wishing seems to be it, so ING has to be it. Fitting? Bingo! Now, please, disengage the lock, would you kindly? Let's see what we got in here. Dead body. I'll take the key. Lunchbox. Burnt books. Harmonica. Is that bubblegum? Apocalypse going on, death and destruction all over the place. But you know what? I need some gum. Medics, pistol, medics, radix. Shit, this is actually a good haul. Mentats. First aid stuff. Blood pack, even though I really don't need it, might as well have it. And I don't have a lockpick of 50. We will be coming back to the hotel for much later because there is something important in here we're going to get. So it's not a big worry if I don't get everything in the first go. Empty sunset sarsaparilla. Who's been drinking all the sunset sarsaparilla, damn it? No. Probably the convicts, so that pretty much answered my own question. Catch register. I'll take that pre-war money. Take these caps. Floor save. Hard. Can't do anything about it because that's actually what we're going to be coming back for, along with the unmarked quest. So, let's go. Should be a fair, decent amount. Yes, this is the door. Now, I want to be really careful because there is an enemy with a heavy weapon up ahead. I don't want him to see me. If I can get the drop on him, we'd go a long way to... Oh, shit.
Found.
Oh, God, dynamite! Oh, God, he's got a flamer! Right, I can't aim for shit while I'm crippled. Please go to your pit boy right now, damn it. Hey, oh god, I'm on fire. Everything is burning. Why is everything burning? Alright, you know what? Screw it. I don't need to aim to smack you in the face. You're dead. Where are you at? I hear dead meat, but I don't see dead. Oh, there you are. Me and my trusty shovel will end you, sir. See? Now that's what you get for being mean. And what have we learned, kids? We learned that if you kill convicts, you get yourself a nice incinerator. I'll take that. Thank you, sir. Egg timer, stim pack. Lots of varmint rifles. How's my varmint rifle doing? That's my cowboy repeater. I don't think I have a varmint rifle ready to go. Oh, they do, but... You know what? Screw it. Let's go in with a plasma rifle, damn it. So, you must be Beagle. Took a little bit of a beating there, but eh, well.
I don't suppose you came here to rescue me. I'd cross my fingers, but my hands are numb.
And you must be Deputy. For redundant much is redundant.
Why, yes I am. It's a pleasure to meet you. I'm in a bit of a predicament here. I'd be most appreciative if you'd set me free.
I hear you may have information on some cons that came this way.
Indeed I do, good sir. And I would be thrilled to share that information with you as soon as I am released from captivity.
You can tell me now, or I'll just leave it a rot here, because, you know, I'm a good person like that.
Well, you look to be a trustworthy sort. Okay, I'll tell you what I know. I overheard them saying that they're on their way to Novak. If you want to follow them, I strongly suggest that you follow the road through Nipton. There are a lot of dangerous things out in the desert. You won't have me with you to protect you, as I need to stay here and keep Prim safe.
You protect me? Huh. Well, maybe I should just leave you. All right, fine.
It would be so very...
Wait, how'd you end up being a hostage anyway?
I must say it's been the low point of my career in law enforcement. The powder gangers stole into town at night and murdered my sister and her husband, the sheriff, in bed while I was sleeping in the office. I watched them for a bit, waiting for the right moment to pounce and arrest the lot of them, taking careful notes as I watched. To my dismay, They found me while I waited in the shadows and brought me here.
Alright, well, I'll get you out. And if you try to run away instead of fighting, well, I'll just kill you myself.
Oh, why, of course.
But no, I'm gonna get you out of here, don't worry. I'm not evil. I'm dangerously good, is probably the best way to describe me. I'm the anti-hero, like Deadpool. I'm also like Deadpool because I'm almost impossible to kill. So let's just get you out of this place and we'll continue on our merry way.
Well, now, breaking myself out of a hostage situation, not to diminish your role in it, of course, but it was quite thrilling. Problem is, there's still no law in Prim. What are we to do the next time ruffians menace us and hold us hot?
What are you talking about? You're the sheriff now.
Oh, no. I'm just the deputy, and I can't be a deputy without a sheriff. It's called chain of command.
Well, what are its qualifications, then?
It should be someone brave like you, but more of a homebody. Someone who'll settle down and watch over us. I heard the Powder Gangers talking about someone in the prison named Myers who has some experience as a sheriff. He may be a good choice. Also, with the NCR so close by, you may be able to get them to take over the town. Not sure why they haven't helped out already.
Hmm. Interesting. We may have to go and help them out with that. In fact, we are going to go and help them out with that, so let's see, quest. And let's take care of my kind of town. We haven't done questifiable stuff. Did I really just say that? Wow. Actually, why did I even come in here? I have no idea. I should be going to the NCR and seeing what they want.
Howdy.
Did your voice just change in between times we talked? Look at that smug bastard walking away like he don't know shit. Alright, well, let's head off and talk to the NCR. Because they're close by. They seem like good, trustworthy people, and oh god. Daniel, no! Wait, who are you again? Express delivery order and a caravaner outfit. Well, I'm a courier, and it's part of the job that I would have one of these, so I'm just gonna just... There, out of sight, out of mind. And total respect for the dead. 308 rounds, 5mm rounds. What is that actually? What does that actually help? There's a jump town. Might as well do that so we can increase our barter by 3. I didn't even know I picked that up. Programmer's Digest, that's science. Lad's Life, that's survival. Duck and Cover, that's actually a skill book, and I will get that so my explosives are now up by 3. I never used the Chinese Army Spec Ops training manual, so I'll do that now so I don't have to waste it. And let's see what the order was. Did it shoot the deputy, but that's just pretty much talking about the cons and stuff. Deliver the package to the north entrance of the Vegas Strip by way of Freeside. An Asian of the recipient will meet you at the checkpoint. Take possession of the package and pay the delivery. Bring the payment to Johnson Nash at Mojave Express Agency in Prim. Bonus compensation 250 caps. Manifest this package contains 2 oversized dice composed of fuzzy material. You're an authorized agent of the Mojave Express package until the delivery is complete. The payment has been processed completely and obliged to the complaint. Yada 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 yada. So basically, it was just one of the special orders that we had to do. His was fuzzy-sided dice, mine was the chip that I got shot in the head for. Apparently, all of us are getting killed over this stuff. Poor, Poor bastards. Anyways, let's head back to Hayes and see if he can help out the town a bit. Sir? You appear to be defying physics. Okay, never mind. Or wait.
If you've got something to say,
I'm sorry, ma'am. That was very wrong of me. I apologize.
Yeah?
Oh, by the way, Prim needs some law.
We know Prim is a great strategic point, and we aren't blind to the needs of the town, but we're barely holding our own against the powder gangers. We don't have the guns or the personnel needed to carry out our mission, much less take on defending this town as well.
What would you need to protect the town, then?
What we need more than anything is bodies. If we had just one more squad, we could easily install a sheriff and still handle our primary objective of protecting the interstate south of here. If you'd like to see the NCR include protection of Prim and its duties, then you'll have to get some more troops up here. Knight at Mojave Outpost may be able to help.
Interesting. I'll look into it. Wait, what?
Yeah.
Who was it again? All right. So we're gonna have to go to the Mojave Outpost and get some reinforcements. I believe, yep, all the way out here. So we got a bit of a walk ahead of us. However, good thing is we got a few rest stops up ahead. So let's go. I feel like we're not going to stop for a good long while. I don't know if I'll probably cut portions in until like something happens or action starts. I may do that because we're pretty much walking a straight out line up to where you can see those two statues up there. So I may just do a little bit of cutting here and there. Wow, that was really bad draw distance. Hello, boys! Good day for a walk? I would agree. Keep on your merry time. Don't mind me. Oh, you really aren't shooting at me.
You better get out of here.
Right. I know the drill. I'm backing up. Ooh, what? Where? Huh? What? Oh. Hey, thanks for the fire support, fellas. Oh. Don't worry. I'll avenge you. Don't run. Don't run. And hey, we leveled up. I'll put Barter up at 30. Medicine 30. Put melee at 25. I'll put repair up to 35 at least. And science, I'll give one to science and give one to speech. Now, what to get? Cannibal perk, you're in sneak mode. You gain the option to eat a corpse and regain your health, but every time you feed, you lose karma, and if the act is witnessed, it is considered a crime against nature. I don't think so. Educated with the comprehension perk, you gain... with the comprehension perk, you gain bonus from reading magazines and an additional point from skill books. Skill books aren't as common as they are for, like they're in Fallout 3. And magazines, we're going to be running across a lot of them. I think I'm going to skip. The Educated Perk, you gain two more skill points every time you advance and level this. Best taken early on to maximize its effectiveness. I think I'm going to do that to maximize its effectiveness. Let's continue on, shall we? Huh, well, isn't that inviting? Daddy's home!
Hey!
Oh, you should... Actually, you know what? No. No left arm. Right arm. Because you have a challenge enabled. Oh, God. I don't like where that knife is going to be swung at. So, you know what? Oh, God, I can't. I did not think I'd send her flying off like that. Look at her. She's about ready to kick my ass with just a bare fist. I'm carrying a freaking shotgun. You're not that smart, are you? And now you're more dead than smart. Hmm? What? Oh. Apparently that mantis got killed somehow. Oh, that was a waste of a shotgun piece. I'll just, bonk. Is there anything good in here? Ooh, some first aid. I will take that. Bonk. Hydra. I didn't want to search the desk. I want that Hydra. We have a dead prospector. Wonder what he has on him. 10mm submachine gun. Damn, that's actually pretty good for this early in the game. 8 clubs, 8 diamonds, some bottle caps. Some dirty water, don't need that. Dog meat, jet, Merc Charmer, Nevada, Scotch. Eh. Nothing else is good besides that 10mm. Which I will hotkey to my right so I have a nice machine gun to go on the fly. Speaking of which, I need to repair that. Done. Now, anything of good use. Anything at the reloading bench? I can make some 9mm rounds. Actually, can I make some 10mm rounds? Case, powder. Not a whole lot left in here. It was just a little rest stop. And I believe that pretty much does it. There's nothing else I can see worthwhile to get in here. Bottle caps, new. Alright, well, let's get going. Oh, hi. You're not gonna try and murder me in the back, are you? I mean, I just saw your friend.
You'd better get out.
All right. I'll comply. I'll grumble all the way, but I will comply. Let's just make our way up to the Mojave Outpost, and I think that will be a decent place to cut it off. There's something here. It doesn't sound good. It's... Oh. Just a bark scorpion. Also, I completely hotkeyed it in the wrong area for my 10mm, so I can't use my shovel for now. Ah well, I haven't been using my 9mm submachine gun for a while, and I have way enough ammo for it aside from my 10mm, so I think we're gonna stick with the 9mm for now. Bad scorpion. Not as easy to kill like a bark scorpion is, but still fairly decent to kill. They're just a normal size one. You're also coming towards me pretty fast. Ow! Oh god, I'm being surrounded. Oh shit. Come on. Oh shit, I'm literally getting surrounded by these damn things. Well, that did shit all. I think it's shotgun time. That's one dead. Wait, where'd the other two go? I don't like the fact that I don't know what happened to the other two. Okay, there's one. And he's coming pretty fast. Freaking little ninjas. Come on. I'd like to kill you guys and not have it take up the end of the entire part. Thank you. Oh god, he's jumping at me. I don't know about you, but if I saw a scorpion that size, even though I killed it, just lunge right at me, I think I'd probably shit my pants. But then again, I think most everyone would if they saw that happen. Whew, I need something heavy for that. Butter knife. Some more caps. Thank you. Wait, what was that? Where's Steven's journal? Should I read that? Pilgrim is illustrated. I believe that is unarmed. Which means I will have no use for it whatsoever. Ooh, gumdrops. Ooh, ammo. Ooh, other shit. Looks like it's nothing but food. And a stim pack. I'll take the stim pack. I don't care about the food. And I didn't need the yeast. Ah, well. We're getting close to the outpost, so I'll have a way of selling it as soon as we get there. Let's just get there and end it off before more scorpions show up, because I really don't want to have to spend, like, 6 more minutes fighting a single scorpion. Oh, God. I just had to say the S word. Well, it's a little one. Not too much trouble. I see a second red dot. I don't like that there's a second red dot. What the? That was weird. Come on. Where are you? Oh, just another small one. Eh, nothing too much. Just don't mind me making my way to the Harvey Outpost every day. Why am I singing? I don't know why. But after this part, I'm gonna get high. I don't know. Well, I do have a lot of chems on me, so who knows. I mean, after all I've run to so far just to get here and just to get to Prim, I think I deserve a little let up on the nerves. I'm just kidding, don't use drugs, kids. Buddy? 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 You okay? You okay? Was my magnificent beard too much for you to handle, so you had to get away from me? The hell? Help. Why is everyone on such high alert?
Hey there. Need anything?
That was weird. Ball cap glasses. Oh boy. Merc Adventure. Metal armor. Never get metal armor, in my opinion, because you lose agility and that it gives you more damage threshold, so more armor. At the cost, you can't use VATS as much, so I'd say avoid metal armor, to be honest. Anti-material rifle suppressor. Ooh. That sounds impressive, but I don't think... Yeah, there's nothing good for sale. You got some ammo and stuff, and that might be... Mini-nuke tiny tots. Ooh. If I had a mini-nuke launcher, I'd definitely get it. I'll take these energy cells, at least. Sell the stuff I don't need, like... I don't need the boxing gloves. I don't need all this dynamite, hell. Sell the frag mines. I could sell the incinerator. I think I might have some use for it. Sell this laser pistol I don't need. Sell this dynamite. Sell the sledgehammer. And this. Nah, I'll keep the tire iron. Bah, screw it. I'll sell it. Anything good here? Not that I can see. Alright. So I think with that little bit of worthlessness out of the way, we finally made it to the Mojave Outpost. I think it's a fair time to end things off here. So next time on Fallout New Vegas, we are going to hopefully get some reinforcements for the NCR and Prim, and hopefully, maybe, we'll finally find someone who can help share the journey with us. See you guys next time. Later.